Hello people, welcome back. So today I will be talking about single displacement reaction. This topic comes under chemistry and chemistry comes under the topic of science. So let's get started. Our content: we have first definition followed by a reactivity series of methods, then the examples, then the questions, and at the last the summary. So definition: reaction in which one element takes place of the other element in a compound is called single displacement reaction. It can be in the form of A plus B minus C, in which A replaces B, which gives you A minus C plus B. Because A is more reactive than B, so that's why A replaces B. I will explain you this reactivity in the next slide. This is the reactivity series of metals. So as you can see, K, that's potassium, Na, sodium, Ca, calcium, Mg, magnesium, Al, aluminium, Zn, zinc, Fe, ferrum. These seven elements are most reactive. But whereas Sn, tin, Pb, lead, Cu, copper, Hg, mercury, Ag, silver, and Au, gold are less reactive. So these seven elements like potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, ferrum, and tin. These seven elements can replace tin, lead, copper, mercury, silver, gold, which is nothing but six elements. As you can see, the first seven elements, they have been categorized as most reactive, and the last six as less reactive. So this was the reactivity series. So let us get to the questions. So, or you can say examples, whatever. So this is CuSO4, which is copper sulfate plus zinc. Since if you go back to a reactivity series table, we know zinc is more reactive than copper. So over here, zinc replaces copper. So you get zinc sulfate plus copper. As I've already seen in a reactive series, that copper is less reactive than zinc, or in other words, you can say zinc is more reactive than copper. Our next example is CuCl2 plus Pb. CuCl2 is nothing but copper chloride plus lead. So again, go back to our reactivity series table. We know that lead, Pb, is at least reactive than copper. Even though lead is less reactive, but elements which are, or metals which are under higher number, are reactive. Since if you see this, copper is just below lead, but since lead is above copper, lead is more reactive than copper. But in the same case, since copper is above gold, copper is more reactive than gold. But since we don't have any, since we don't have gold in any question, right now we can ignore it. So in this question, we are talking about lead and copper. So lead, Pb, is more reactive than copper. So yeah, so yes, which gives you, after doing these two equation, you get PbCl2 plus Cu, that's lead chloride plus copper. This lead replaces copper, as lead is more reactive than copper, as you have already seen in the reactivity series. Now the last example is CuO, that's nothing but copper oxide plus magnesium. Since magnesium is more reactive than copper, see where's magnesium at number 4 and where's copper. Sorry, magnesium is 4th from the top and magnesium is 4th from the bottom. So even though it is copper is in bottom, so magnesium is high reactive than copper. So that's why magnesium replaces copper, which gives you MgO plus Cu. MgO stands for magnesium oxide and Cu stands for copper. So these were three examples. So yeah, these were three examples. But there are many more examples that follows. But since I'm just telling you the basics, I will only give you these examples. So now now we come to a part where most of people don't like doing it, but still have to do it. does nothing but the questions. But you, I can guarantee you that whenever we come to the topic of questions, this should be the reaction in your face. But what to do? The only way to make sure that you understand the concept is only by questions. So I would say don't cry, but do your best to try to solve these questions. Because in case if you solve these questions, you do sometimes get praised. So yeah. So if you want, you can write these questions down. 2 times of Fe2O3 plus 3 times of C gives what? And Zn plus 2 times HCl gives what? Let me tell you. Fe stands for ferrous. So that's okay. So Fe2O3, that's 2 times of Fe2O3 plus 3C gives what? So let me just tell you what does Fe2O3 stands for. So that I will discuss with you in the next video, because as I discuss the answers, you will also get to know what is Fe2O3. So until then, just if you have noted down the question, we can move to the next slide, which is a summary. Or if you want, I'll wait for some 2 more minutes or say a few seconds. So our next slide basically consists of summary, which you should be remembering it. So I guess you are done with all the questions. So writing down the question. So let's go to our summary, which is nothing but the last slide. And I forgot to tell you one thing. You can put your answers in the comments, and I will discuss the answers in my next video. Now is a summary. The reaction in which one element takes place of other element in a compound is called single displacement reaction. It is in the form of A plus B minus C, in which A replaces B, which gives you A minus C plus B. And this is one of the most important part. In order to solve any displacement reaction, it is necessary to know the reactivity series of metal. Now you people would be thinking, seriously? But yes, you have to learn the reactivity series in order to solve any reactive questions, whether that comes with the single displacement reaction or double displacement reaction. So then, bye guys, I'll see you later in my next video, and thank you for watching. And make sure to like, share and subscribe this video so that many new kids can get to know what single displacement reaction is. Thank you.